Hey guys, well, it's another weekend, and this weekend I'm going to see if I can't get some of that brush pulled out of there that I talked to you about in the last video. We're going to be burning in the new fire spot, and it's kind of late, so I guess it's time to get the show on the road. Well, I got this brush down all the way to the line over here on this side. I also pushed a lot of the brush that was just lying down right here over to the burn pit. I hate to say it, but I guess it's time to quit. But we got quite a bit done. There's still some piles of brush over there that I didn't push. It's just getting too dark, and there's a wet spot right down in that little dip. I can't really get the tractor through it and push brush at the same time. So I'm gonna have to pull that out by hand probably. Once I get this all cleaned up, get the brush all over to the burn pit, I can start clearing the middle here. Not much in the middle. A lot of this was already done with the lopers, but there's a lot of little stumps I gotta dig. I'll get those dug up. Here you can see a few of them. Here I am loosening up the brush that I pushed over with the tractor. Pushing it over with the tractor gets it all knotted up, and it kind of rolls it into a ball and gets it really tight, which makes it really difficult to get it apart so that the people who are doing the burning can get it onto the fire. Well, there's that red flag that I tried to show you in an earlier video. There's the pole I keep referring to. In the center area here, I got to pull out some brush today, but I didn't get to pull out as much as I would have liked to have. I spent most of my time today dragging brush that I pulled out along the other side. All this brush in through here. I've still got some more cleaning up to do. I've got, you know, some it's right there, got some in there, and I've got some over in here. Got a wet spot right in here, and getting the brush out of here was kind of difficult. I thought maybe I could just pull it out by hand, but unfortunately it was just too entangled and too piled up. I had to get the tractor in there, and it didn't work out very well. It was pretty muddy. I couldn't go anywhere and push it, so I had to get up on the other end of that little knoll there, and I had to drag it out with the backhoe. So I spent a good deal of my time today doing that and taking that over to the burn area. So I guess it's time to start picking up, call it a night. I'm gonna take the tractor and spread that fire out, and we'll hose it down.
I sure you might be wondering why I don't just take the tractor and just push the brush right onto the fire and not have to worry about breaking it up and putting it on by hand, but we're right close to the power lines in this area, and it's very important that we keep the fire kind of low. I don't want to push a lot of brush onto the fire and get a tall fire, especially since we're in such close proximity to the power lines.